Moment of Dick Vitale. It is alive. It is very, very purple here in Little Manhattan tonight. What are you looking for in this game tonight, Dick?
Well, I think it comes down to number one. They got to make shots from the perimeter. When you talk about Poland, he's going to have to make that perimeter shot. On the interior, they got to get on the offensive glass. I'll tell you what really amazes me. They go to the free throw line more than any team in America. Will they get to that free throw line? Can they beat number one and number two in about 3 weeks? That's an amazing achievement. You said the octagon of doom. This place is rocking. It's electric, baby.
This is a program that's come a long, long way. They set a game day record for the most number of fans here to watch the morning show today. Let's check out the Star Watch right now. We got a big guy and we got a little guy, Dick.
Well, you talk about the big guy, Cole Aldridge. He seems to be finding his game lately. Shot blocker, a guy that could score inside. I think he could be the difference maker. On the other side, Poland struggling shooting the ball in league play. Came back strong against Baylor with 25. They need his shot. He was 2 for 15 against Texas, but they were able to survive.
For more on tonight's game, let's check in with Aaron Andrews, EA.
All right, Dan, thanks so much. Well, with Kentucky losing this week, there is the talk that if Kansas is able to beat Kansas State here at home tonight, they will likely be number one when the new poll comes out. So I asked Jayhawks head coach Bill Self, how did he approach this with his team? And he said, this time I didn't ignore it. You see, when the Jayhawks were number one for 9 straight weeks, he said they didn't mention it at all. This time he said, listen, let's embrace being number one. Let's play like a number one team. He doesn't want them to forget about what could happen if they win tonight and that new poll comes out. Dan?
All right, Aaron, so a lot on the line here in this building tonight. Thanks for watching the Infinity College Basketball Tip-Off as tonight's coaches steer us into a Big 12 battle.
A stroke of inspiration presented by Infinity.
If it's worth having, it's worth working for.
You never go into that game thinking that you can't. You go into that game figuring out a way that you can.
Against K-State, it's going to be a game of who wants it the most.
Because it's about us, about who we strive to be.
Has been brought to you by the Infiniti G Sedan.
Welcome back to Bramlage Coliseum here in Manhattan, Kansas, the home of the K-State Wildcats. And welcome to Saturday Primetime, presented by DirecTV, a part of ESPNU Campus Connection Week, number 2 KU, number 13 K-State. K-State having as good a year, Dick, as they've had in a long, long time. They beat KU in this building 2 years ago. They'd love to do it again here tonight and deny Kansas a chance at regaining the top spot in the rankings. So look at the starting lineups. We begin with Kansas, of course, led by Sharon Collins at the point and Cole Aldrich in the middle. But Marcus Morris playing his best basketball right now, better than 18 a game in conference play. For Kansas State, a team that really brings it, really plays hard, especially here in this building. Denny Clemente, great speed. Jacob Pullen, 6 threes in his last game. And the guys up front will have to do a number on Aldridge and the Morris twins for K-State to have a good shot here tonight.
Bill Self told me before the game he thinks they're the best offensive rebounding team in America. He said they really get on the glass, and that's one of the reasons, if you look for reasons, why they lead the nation going to the free throw line. It's aggressive play, Dan. They are very aggressive. And you know, they reached a point in their program, it's not about moral victories and playing Kansas tough. You want respect and credibility, you have to beat them on your home floor. This is your home floor.
And that's where Frank Martin is trying to take this program. NCAA 2 years ago with Michael Beasley, NIT last year, 17-3, some very nice wins against ranked teams this year. But this is the game that everybody's focusing on and looking at as they check out the progress of this K-State program.
I think the tone for aggressiveness was established when they hired a man by the name of Robert Huggins. when Robert Huggins came here, Bob Huggins, he set the tone and has rubbed off on his assistant, Frank Morton, and he's continued that mental toughness. I don't know why they're giving us high fives. Kansas players
Marcus Morris
just
giving us high fives.
Play. You playing?
Hey,
I'm not playing.
Hey, we're lucky to go to a lot of places, Dick, but few of them have the atmosphere that this place has.
To keep this environment electric, they have to get off to a good start. They can allow the Jayhawks to come out here quiet and really silence the crowd.
They will meet later on in the season in Lawrence. KU has won 25 of the last 26 games they've played here in Manhattan. The only loss was when Michael Beasley was here 2 years ago. Scott Thornley, Duke Etzel, Paul Jansen, our officials, were underway with a Kansas turnover.
And a little set play right there. Look at that speed on Clemente.
He got away with it. Sutton had the shot altered at the rim, and back come the Jayhawks. A frenetic pace here to begin the game.
Sharon Collins from out of Chicago. Pulling from out of Proviso East. They know each other from the scholastic ranks. Played in a lot of AAU competition, summer leagues.
Matt Collins a year older than Pullen, but they actually embraced one another as their shoot-arounds overlapped earlier today. They go back a long way, as you say. Aldrich defended by Luis Colon and the soft touch on the jump hook.
He's starting to become much more effective offensively. Had a few problems, really, had bronchitis, and also had the problem with his love for his grandmother passed away.
His grandmother, after a long illness, passed away earlier this season, but he is starting to play his best basketball at preseason All-American. Jacob Pullen, the pull-up from about 16 feet. And the rebound to Marcus Morris, who has really come on strong, Dick, in conference play.
Yeah, he's become very aggressive. On the other side of the ledger, Xavier Henry has really struggled in conference play, shooting like 28%.
Brady Morningstar off to Morris. Morningstar. Henry for... And Henry stepped out of bounds before he launched that shot as KU turns it over for the second time.
You're going to watch Aldridge get the ball in deep. Once he gets it in here and spins to the lane, he's so tough. He's so tough. He's a preseason All-American. Hadn't played like an All-American early, but it's starting to really come on. 7 block shots in the game against Missouri, when he dominated Missouri.
And Dick, Frank Martin does not like to double in the post very much at all, so whoever's defending Aldrich is not going to get a whole lot of help tonight.
Well, they're a tough team to double because they had so many other good players in the other position.
Curtis Kelly, the transfer from UConn, misses it. Offensive rebound, Sutton. Foul, Aldrich.
And the three left-handed players on our front court. When you look at Kansas State, that's a little unique look. I went up in the crowd today, had a lot of fun with all these students. They're all fired up, man.
This is something. We saw them lining up. They had a system worked out so you didn't have to line up for days in advance where there was, an online lottery. You got your spot in line, but they were lined up for hours today. And it's estimated, Dick, there were over 8,000 people here for game day this morning. And there's an illegal screen, a foul on Luis Colon of K-State.
One thing about K-State, they'll be very physical. They are very aggressive. I think a key in the game is going to be the way the officials blow the whistle.
Yep.
Do they allow them to have that tenacity and that physical stature, which comes from their coach, Frank Morton?
Kansas State gets to the free throw line more than any team in the country. They draw more fouls than any team in the country. But they commit more fouls than just about any team in the country. Now we got one going the other way. It'll be on Henry.
You're right about that. They're fifth in the nation in committing fouls, but they really get after it. They lead the nation 659, Seattle number 2, Wyoming number 3, New Mexico number 4.
So expect a lot of whistles in this game, but expect a ton of intensity as well.
Watch the speed and quickness in number 21, Clemente. Cousin of, second cousin, Roberto Clemente.
Late baseball star, the Hall of Famer. Tough shot. Colon on the offensive glass. Off the back of the rim.
There's that offensive rebound that they self-talked about. They're going to get a third opportunity.
All the students directly across from us, all of them are standing here with the Bramlage. This is Sutton. He's a defender, not really a big-time scorer. This is the score, Pullen. And back comes Sharon Collins.
You got to watch his numbers now. He's 0 for 2. He's a very streaky kind of shooter. If he gets on fire, They won that game against Texas. He was 2 for 15.
Amazing. Brady Morningstar misses the three. Marcus Morris is called for the offensive foul. The official, Paul Jansen, said he used that left arm to create a little space.
Bill Self, what an amazing job he has done. Phenomenal since replacing Roy Williams, the Hall of Famer. They're going to get him with the left arm. Oh, I don't know about that call.
So a foul on Marcus Morris, who still doesn't like it. His twin brother, Markeith, has now checked into the game for Aldridge. So Marcus Morris and Cole Aldridge, each with an early foul in the front court for Kansas. Bologna Sr., who missed the first 9 games this year for an off-the-court issue that has since been resolved.
How do you get a good screen?
Kelly. Nice pass. Sutton inside. Got it. And K-State is on the board.
Nice look by Kelly. Came the way of Connecticut. A transfer. Marco Polo seems to fit him perfectly here.
It was Kelly, one of the guys who had a huge game in the win a week and a half ago over Texas. Nice drive by Xavier Henry. That's what Bill Self wants to see more of from the freshman.
Yeah, he wants to see him be a little bit more aggressive and attack the basket rather than look for the perimeter shot.
He's got tremendous athleticism. Good position down low. Good double team on Kelly, who's called for a travel, and he thought he was bodied off of the spot.
You're right. Kelly had a big game against Texas. He and Samuels, 37 points, 20 rebounds. Did a terrific job on the interior because the guards didn't shoot well.
And here comes Samuels, number 32, 20 points, 12 rebounds off the bench in that win over Texas. He's got starter's ability, but he prefers to come off the bench. Kind of surveys the situation. Feels very comfortable when he comes into the game.
Brings a lot of energy off that bench, too.
Collins misses. Rebound Sutton. K-State looking to push. Look at the speed on Clemente. Sutton with the offensive rebound.
There they are on the glass again.
Kelly with the finish.
Really doing a job on the offensive board. When you're on the offensive glass, that means you're playing aggressive. And they love it here. The Octagon of Doom. Oh, the Octagon of Doom is rocking.
5 offensive rebounds already for K-State. Morningstar slips all the way to the goal.
Too easy. He gained his eligibility December 19th. Had some problems off the court.
Arrested DUI. Under suspicion of DUI back before the season and was suspended by Bill Self for the first semester. Good defender, good shooter. Pull in. Boy, that's a lot of contact for a play on. Henry.
Oh, he blocked.
And there's the travel call. Another Kansas turnover. That's one of the early themes of the game. And, Dick, as you talked about, K-State hitting the offensive glass, one of the early themes of this game as well.
Yeah, it really is an early theme. Here they are climbing on the glass right now, showing that ability to really attack the boards.
Exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV. To get the most out of your high-def TV, you gotta hook it up to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. And in part by Subway Restaurants. Eat smart with a turkey melt, part of a Subway Fresh Fit meal.
Years ago tonight, the only time that a K-State has ever defeated a KU in this building, as Kansas has won 20 of 21 in this building, 25 of the last 26 in this city, and overall a dominant 177-90. This is the 8th longest continuous running rivalry in college basketball.
Well, you can't have a rivalry unless you can compete. They have lost 31 in a row. 31 overall in a row. It's unbelievable how they dominated Kansas.
Tyshawn Taylor, number 10, into the game for Kansas. He draws the assignment of Denny Clemente as K-State turns it over.
Taylor can be a very vital player. He played well against them last year. He's sort of been up and down this year. Has not been the player they expected. He was the leading scorer for the USA, 19 and under team. They led him to the championship. Jamie Dixon coached him.
A couple of off-the-court situations. Yeah. Of course, the fight between the basketball team and the football team. Facebook as well. Aldrich inside for the slam. And that's maybe the biggest question of the night for Kansas State. How do they and who defends Cole Aldrich? Because no matter who they have on him, they're giving up some size.
Well, you're giving up size, but you're also giving up size to a guy who knows how to play.
Yeah.
He's a good post player. He's going to get more touches inside, trying to double up on the interior.
Boy, Kansas very aggressive doubling in the post. Look at the spin move by Jamar Samuels.
Samuels shows you why he's so effective coming off the bench. Great drop step. One-on-one maneuver inside against Aldridge and gets the layup.
Oh, Sutton reaching in is called for the foul as we check out that Samuels spin move at the other end of the court.
I got a feeling you like the spin move the way you call it. It was a great drop step. Tremendous reverse maneuver. There he is, exploding to the basket, laying on the glass.
And Frank Martindick going even deeper into his bench as Rodney Magruder, a 6'4 freshman out of Washington, checks in. Also, Nick Russell, a 6'4 freshman out of Duncanville, Texas. K-State will go 10 or 11 deep on many nights.
You know, Magruder can shoot the ball. He's got four consecutive games, double figures.
Markeith Morris, and a foul.
They're getting the ball inside too easily, Kansas. Right now, the two big stars have not scored. The two kids are out of Windy City when you talk about Poulin and Collins. Clemente either. The big three, we expect to put a lot of points on the board. So far, they got Ziggy, baby. They got Zip.
The foul on Luis Colon, his second, as Markeith Morris heads to the line. Marcus has become the bigger story, the bigger contributor so far this year, but both of the twins effective and very important. As Bill Self goes to his bench again, Tyrell Reed will check in for Brady Morningstar, one shooter in for another.
Well, Reed, the last game against Missouri, he was 4-for-4, yep, shooting the three. You know, I see the Morrises, I see Henry, one face comes jumping right at me. John Calipari.
Yeah.
I mean, he must wield some magic because those kids originally committed to Memphis.
That's
the
right.
Morris kids. And then Henry committed to go there as well.
Yeah. Coach Cal's doing okay, though. He's got some talent there.
I tell you what, they bounced back against a good Vanderbilt team. And they showed a lot of pride.
Beat Vanderbilt handily today. Kentucky will drop out of the number one spot because of their loss. A Kansas win here tonight. They could get it, but Danny Clemente says not so fast.
He's a transfer Marco Polo guy. Came from Miami.
Where Frank Martin is from.
He likes this system here.
Hey, good play there by Markeith Morris. A heady play, bouncing it off the back of Nick Russell to retain possession for the Jayhawks.
You know, you mentioned he comes from Miami, coached at Miami Senior High School. Coached guys like Udonis Haslam in high school. He coached Brent Wright, who went to Florida. And he coached Steve Blake, who played for Gary Williams of Maryland.
Martavius Irving in off the K-State bench now, number three, backup point guard. Nick Russell went to the bench.
He got himself a good one, baby. Yeah. He's going to be an intense, passionate battle all night long.
And Marcus Morris in for Markeith. Nice look to Tyshawn Taylor. He explodes to the baseline. And the follow is good by Cole Aldrich, who is really asserting himself inside.
Yeah, he's really becoming aggressive on the interior. Had a really big game against Missouri.
Aldrich with six already. Floater short by Clemente. He'll get another look.
Oh, he kissed it off the glass. You think he shot it that way?
Well, he's not smiling, but he'll take it.
Tell you one thing. His second cousin, Roberto, had a rifle. You talk about a rifle. What a great humanitarian. Trying to help people in need on the 31st, 1972 in Nicaragua, lost his life.
Now let's take a look at his second cousin, Denny Clemente, and what he brings to the table.
He brings a long-range jumper. He told me the reason he transferred, he likes the system. It's all about the system. There's the bank shot. The bank must be open. Timmy Brando said the bank's open.
A good start for Clemente, a good start for Aldrich for KU. Sharon Collins has gone to the bench. And checking in for him was Xavier Henry. So it's Tyshawn Taylor at the point right now for KU. Aldrich 3-for-3 in the early going. Nice move, and he draws the foul on Wally Judge, a freshman out of Washington, D.C.
Well, you can see their game plan is to bring the ball inside to Aldrich today. really getting him a lot of touches on the inside, forcing Kansas State to try to match up with the All-American.
Aldridge coming off back-to-back double-doubles, and you can see the numbers he's put together in his last two games, starting to play like everybody expected him to play this season.
Had 16 rebounds against Missouri, 12 points, 7 block shots. Had one of his great, great games in the NCAA tournament last year, a triple-double against Dayton. Had 10 block shots in that game and 20 rebounds.
And he had the breakout game in his freshman season against North Carolina.
Yeah, that was the game that he came out of, was his, really his game of arriving as a college player.
Right. He'll sit down now. Markieff Morris back in. We see both coaches going to the bench on almost every opportunity because of the pace and intensity of this game here tonight. Clemente playing off the ball now with Irving running the show. Clemente both a scorer and a distributor for the Wildcats. Samuels knocks it down from three.
There's no way he's a bench player. That guy's a legitimate big-time college player.
And a hold on Kansas State. It's going to be on the demonstrative, emotional Samuels as he picks up the foul number two on him. Some foul trouble in the early going for K-State, but they do have a two-point lead on KU.
Get to his house. He has 13 monkeys.
You know, there's something I've been wanting to tell you. I love you.
And I...
so cute. Another Miller Lite?
I'd love one. Thank you.
Do you love the taste of your beer this much? Well, you could. Try the great Pilsner taste of a triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
You're gorgeous. Look at you. I love you.
That's as good a week as there is in a college basketball. Coming to you a week from now, some of the great rivalries. You saw Kansas, Texas, Tennessee, and Vandy, Connecticut, Syracuse, Duke, Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky. What more can you say, Dick? These are not only great rivalries, but look at all the numbers. Look at all those rankings, how good all of these teams are.
Unbelievable. Syracuse almost bit the dust today against the ball, but they were able to survive and win on the road. They went down big, came back. We'll be at those last two games, Duke, Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky.
That's right. And by the way, we talked about how they set a record here in Manhattan for the largest game day crowd of better than 8,000 people. We understand that they have already sold out Rupp Arena for the game day morning show, better than 20,000 people.
Are you shocked about that? Anything they do better. Yep. They got the most passionate fans in all of America. They love their Wildcats.
Henry into a triple team, and here comes Magruder. Samuels has gone to the bench with two fouls. He and Cologne, two Wildcats, each with two fouls already.
They're a very deep basketball team, a very aggressive team, physically, defensively.
Foul on Markieff Morris as we check in with Aaron Andrews.
Dan, just keeping an eye on Jacob Pullen for Kansas State. He was having a coughing fit there in that timeout. A couple coaches asked him if he was doing okay. He actually went over to the trash can. I don't know if he was clearing his throat or getting sick. He seems fine since that timeout, but I got to tell you, a few coaches looked concerned, saying, "You all right? You all right?" Hasn't seen him coughing out there, though, right now.
Well, we're talking about the second leading scorer in the Big 12 at a better than 19 points per game. Tough pass in traffic, but another foul on KU. This one on Sharon Collins.
First 14 games this year, he was on fire, shooting 46% from the three, 45% field goal, at 28-30 back-to-back. There he is, coughing. He had 28-30 back-to-back against UNLV and against Alabama. Then he went through a real schneid in Big 12 play. He really struggled until that game with Baylor.
Had a back-to-back 2-for-15 games. Amazing that K-State beat Texas, then ranked number one, with Clemente and Pullen combining to go 4-for-24 from the field.
had a great win against Baylor. That's a good Baylor basketball team to beat Texas today.
In Austin, Clemente. Out of bounds to Kansas.
You know what they're really facing right now when you look at Kansas State? Kansas enters today fourth in the nation in scoring. Number three is Villanova. Number two is Texas. Number one, VMI.
And Kansas also holding the opponents to under 62 points per game. Great offensively, great defensively.
Great offensive rebound right there by Andrew. Didn't convert though.
Clemente in transition.
I would like to see a race between Clemente and Lucas from out of Michigan State with the ball in their hands.
Good hands by Kelly. Aldridge got it back. Here comes Collins. The lob, Tyshawn Taylor.
Great look by Collins to Taylor. Last year, one of the real diaper dandies in the conference. Big 12 has so many good basketball players over the years. He had an outstanding year. Played for Bob Hurley at St. Anthony's.
You know, you look at Kansas, Dick, and Aldridge struggled a little bit early, and Taylor hasn't had maybe as good a season as they had hoped. And what are they? 19-1, ranked second in the country, even though they apparently haven't been clicking on all cylinders so far.
I was teasing Bill Self for what again, because he looks so relaxed. As I guess 19-1 will make
that'll
you feel
it.
Of it.
Yeah.
I'd say it's a great personality to handle the pressures of coaching in an environment and replacing a legend like Roy Williams.
Hand off to Magruder as K-State runs a little clock this possession. Pull it. And Judge may not have been expecting the pass. He got it, and he finishes.
He converted on the inside with a little jump hook. Poulin trying to show he's unselfish, play the proviso east. Going to produce players such as Doc Rivers, Shannon Brown, D. Brown, Michael Finley.
Big Monday presented by Bud Light is on ESPN with a Big East Big 12 doubleheader. First, it'll be UConn, which lost at home today to Marquette, taking on Louisville at 7 Eastern, then at 9 Eastern. It'll be Texas against James Anderson at Oklahoma State as Texas looks to avenge a loss from a season ago to the Cowboys.
Tell you, want to see a great player? Watch that game at Oklahoma State and see James Anderson. Anderson against Damian James, who holds the Big 12 record for most double-doubles.
You saw the look on that Frank Martin is sporting tonight, the suit and the sneakers. This is an initiative by college basketball coaches, a joint initiative between the NABC and the American Cancer Society to raise awareness for cancer research and funding for cancer research. And hundreds of coaches are wearing either suits and sneakers or just sneakers and more casual clothing around college basketball this weekend.
I think that's great. We're going to be the V Foundation where the coaches for cancer raise money to fight that dreaded disease.
Deep three, Collins.
Right now, Collins has not scored, and neither has Poulin. The two kids from out of Chicago, the two stars.
Another offensive rebound for Aldridge, but it won't stay down for him. Clemente for three. Way off. Marcus Morris.
You're being very kind.
By saying way off?
That was way, way off. Good ball reversal.
Good position. And one.
What great execution. Reversing the ball, swinging it side to side. The extra pass, creating the angle to make the post entry. What a terrific job of reversing that basketball. Watch them utilize the post. Perfect 45-degree angle.
You know what, Dick? Since Morningstar's comeback, people have talked about, hey, he can shoot, and hey, he's a really good defender. But Bill Self says all of the big guys' numbers are up because Brady Morningstar can really feed the post.
He can feed the post, but you know what else he brings? The ability to shoot the three makes the defense have to respect him, and it's tough to double up on Aldridge. You know, you mentioned cancer research. A couple of my friends are in the house here. He gave us over six figures for the V Foundation. Cody Foster and his buddies are in the house from out of Advisors of Self, from out of Kansas. I can't thank them enough. Six figures of donation.
With Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Dan Shulman. It's Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. Jacob Poulin scoreless through almost 12 minutes. Kansas and K-State tied at 16. This is Poulin with the ball, 19 points per game, second of the Big 12 to James Anderson of Oklahoma State.
He hasn't scored, and neither was his buddy Collins.
Clemente, another miss and another rebound for Marcus Morris.
So Marcus Morris, he has really improved.
Collins switches hands. Still loose in the corner, and Markeith Morris runs it down. Marcus for three.
He really has elevated his game, Dan. He's a much better player than we saw earlier this year.
You're not kidding. So Marcus knocks down the three, and twin brother Markeith gets the assist.
Volley of minutes gives you some confidence, and that's what's happened in this game. They cannot win this game, Kansas State, unless Pooling gets going. They need his shot.
There he is running around, a couple of baseline screens, but Morningstar stays right with him. Clemente. Kelly turns it over.
He's too valuable. I know they got to play against Texas. They won that game. But tonight, they will not win unless he starts putting some points on the board. He's too important to this club.
Good look inside. Marcus Morris for two more. They're getting the ball inside way too easily.
Yeah, I was just going to say, but Coach Schulman beat me to the point. I think they're getting the ball on the entry to that post.
And a foul on Tyshawn Taylor to take us to immediate timeout. An injured Jayhawk. We'll sort it out for you when we come back. Markeith Morris is down. KU leading by five.
Mike Ham with a SportsCenter in-game update. Vikings offensive tackle Bryant McKinney has been dismissed from the NFC Pro Bowl team for missing practice on both Friday and Saturday. This was the first Pro Bowl selection for McKinney. Baylor and Texas needed overtime to decide a winner. The Bears get it done behind Tweety Carter's 27 points, tying a season high. Next SportsCenter after the X Games on ESPN at 11 Eastern time.
And back here in Manhattan at the Bramlage Coliseum, Dan Schulman, Dick Vitale, Airman Andrews, Kansas, and Kansas State. And an injury just before the last break, Dick. 21 in blue, Markeith Morris. Looked like he stepped on somebody's foot, rolled that ankle, and he has hobbled off the court and all the way into the locker room. So Cole Aldrich will come back into the game. Aldrich with 8 points and 3 rebounds thus far.
I think the big number right now, when you look certainly at Kansas State, is their great guard combination is 2 for 12. 2 for 12 is not going to get it done against a quality team like Kansas.
Let's get an update from EA.
And Dan, just another injury to tell you about. Sherron Collins has been grimacing for the past 3-4 minutes, actually right when that injury happened to Morris. He came over to the sidelines. It's his right knee. He keeps trying to bend down and stretch it out. Like I said, looks like he's got some pain on his face there.
Tell you one thing, there's a lot of pain on that floor and a lot of physical contact.
Yep. No love lost between these two programs. Pull up by Taylor, his first points of the night.
Squared up his body really well. Proviso East High School, big time scoring ability, 28 and 30 back to back against the Rebels. UNLV and Lon Kruger, who's an outstanding player here at Kansas State.
Pullen also growing that beard before the season. That's inspired the fear the beard signs here as Kelly shows his hops.
Time to shave the beard, my friend.
You don't like the beard?
A guy wrote a column, Joshua Kinda, and I couldn't agree more. It's time to shave it. He went a little bit slow. Get the Gillette blade out, man. Right at center court.
He says Curtis Kelly won't let him. One of his teammates says you got to keep it. It's not for superstitious reasons or anything. As Collins slips inside for the layup.
Collins says anything you could do, I could do better. Jacob, we're both from Chicago.
First points of the night for Pullen, then first points of the night for Collins. Collins, of course, one of the very best point guards in college basketball, a senior, and a big part of that national championship team a couple of years ago.
Yeah, so strong with the basketball, very physical, aggressive player.
Kelly from 17, in and out. Rebound, Marcus Morris.
They got a dynamite front court when you think about Aldridge and Morris, he developed in Xavier Henry.
I haven't seen Henry in a few minutes here tonight. Aldrich, kind of a running hook. Marcus Morris, another good rebound, but he missed one from 2-3 feet away. Pulling for three.
He's streaky, baby. He can get on fire. He drains the trifecta. Great follow through. He can be on 5 in a row. He's that kind of player. 6 out of 7 against Baylor.
Jeff, what an atmosphere here tonight, huh?
Oh, phenomenal. Phenomenal atmosphere.
Tyrell Reed floats one in off the glass. That'll quiet him down for a bit.
Tell you, those role players know their roles. They're such good complementary players. When you think about the people that don't get a lot of recognition for Kansas like Reed.
They've got shooters, defenders, youth and experience, a great point guard, a big man. They certainly appear to have all the pieces to make another deep run.
and a well coach. I mean, Bill Self is one of the premier coaches, and close to the 400 mark in his career.
Sweet 16 a year ago, and everybody back from last season.
He did a phenomenal job with the Fighting Illini. We will be next week. Yeah. The Orange Crush, great fans down here.
And Tulsa before that, a travel called on Kelly. ESPN kicks off Super Bowl week from South Florida tomorrow when McDonald's presents the 2010 Pro Bowl at 7:20 Eastern. The NFL's top stars on one stage the Sunday before the Super Bowl. Coverage begins with Sunday NFL Countdown at 5:30 Eastern.
You know, everybody making a big thing about the Pro Bowl. How could you approve it? It's an exhibition. That's all it's supposed to be. It's an exhibition. Have fun.
Reed driving on Clemente. Couldn't get around him.
Clemente's got the superb quickness.
Reed and the Morningstar in the game together. Morningstar off to Marcus Morris. Look at Aldrich. Another offensive rebound, and he's headed to the free throw line.
He's headed to some big numbers on the glass here tonight.
It's his fifth rebound of the night. He's got 8 points as he heads to the line.
An amazing story. I mean, look at Kansas and their numbers. They're approaching the 2000th win in a career, University of great tradition. Bill Self, they've won five consecutive Big 12 titles.
That's amazing.
I mean, that's dominance. Yeah. That's against good quality teams.
Well, remember everything they lost from the national championship team 2 years ago, brought back Collins and Aldrich, but everybody else was either new or stepping into a much larger role, and they won the league again.
Well, anytime you get a combination of star on the perimeter and the inside, like Collins and Aldridge, you're talking two legit All-Americans, Dan.
Well, Dick, I'll tell you, Frank Martin is working the officials hard. He is as intense a coach on the sideline as there is in America. He, protege, I guess, of Bob Huggins, of course, came here with Bob Huggins, and Huggins spent 1 year here, then went to his alma mater at West Virginia, Frank Martin taking over. But Frank Martin says, you know what, this is who I am, and my players are okay with it. But, boy, he's got fire in his eyes as he stalks the sideline.
You know, a lot of people didn't think that he should have this job. When Huggins left, they thought, hey, not enough experience. He has earned the points of many of the people here, recruiting, coaching, getting to play intense.
Kelly knocks down a jumper. K-State back within three.
I think there are a lot of high school coaches have given the opportunity.
Yep.
Life is about opportunity, taking advantage of it, and Frank Martin's taking advantage of a golden opportunity.
Pulling the foul, 1-1 for KU after the timeout. Kansas up three here in Manhattan.
Ole Miss battles Kentucky, then Michigan State, Wisconsin, Tuesday on ESPN.
So what do you get if you mix Jacob Pullen and Dick Vitale?
Hey, I'm going to get a toupee, too. I'm going to get a toupee. Why not?
You don't have a toupee? Coming up next on the UPS Halftime Report with Reese Davis, Hubert Davis, Digger Phelps, and Jay Billis. What a win for Georgetown today over Duke. Texas loses again. Baylor gets them in Austin, and a closer look at Northwestern as well. Fear the beard. The beard is all the rage here in Manhattan. It's great to see a program. They've had some success. You got to go back a while, but it's great to see this program get up off the mat, have the success, and get the fans back in the building.
Well, so many great coaches here. Think about Cotton Fitzsimmons over the years. Jack Hartman was a terrific coach. I think about guys like Orlando Blackman was a great player here. Bob Boozer years ago, before you were ever around. Bob Boozer was terrific. Hey, that beard, I'm going to grow one now. I think I'm going to grow one.
I think you should.
Yeah.
Mitch Richmond, another great player who played here.
Tex Winter coached here.
That's right.
Tex Winter has done a phenomenal job over the years. The Lakers should be in a Hall of Fame.
First free throw knocked down by Taylor, a very important guy for this Kansas team. As we said earlier, some off-the-court issues and hasn't had quite the season they had hoped for, but the talent is there.
Oh, he's talented. Played for a great high school coach. Talk about Hall of Fame. See, I'm so easy, I want to put them all in the Hall of Fame. Bob Hurley belongs in the Hall of Fame. He's contributed so much to basketball as a high school coach back in Jersey.
As we mentioned off the top of the show, Kansas has won 25 of their last 26 games in Manhattan. The only loss 2 years ago, but Michael Beasley was a Wildcat. Aldrich brings down another rebound.
He has the excellent outlet pass. A la Bill Walton, they take that over-the-head pass years ago. Wes Unser was really phenomenal way before your time again with Louisville and in the NBA.
Aldrich having a big first half, 9 points, five rebounds. Marcus Morris, 7 points and eight rebounds. Aldrich over Judge, left it short. Here come the Wildcats.
Tell you one thing about Kansas, they get back defensively in transition. You don't get layups. They really make you play 5-on-5.
Sutton, the handoff to Pullen. Cold early, then knocked down a couple of long jumpers.
Kansas switching on that ball screen.
K-State having to go a lot of minutes without Cologne and Samuels because of foul trouble, so they need guys like Judge to pick up the slack.
That's a big deuce right there. Kansas enters today, second in the nation of field goal defense. Florida State is number one. We saw them the other day against Duke.
They picked up a road win today, winning up to BC. It's going to be K-State ball. Pullen deflected it off the fingertips of Taylor out of bounds.
They just got to make certain they don't allow a spurt by Kansas. They want to keep this crowd in the game and a chance to win if they can get the winning time in the last 4 minutes. The crowd could play a major, major factor at the end of the game.
And Samuels is back into the game. He was very good when he was in there early, picked up a couple of fouls, but now some momentum shifting here in this game. K-State's got the ball back, and he and Magruder both come back in.
Tell you one thing, can be a factor at the end of the game. Not a good free throw shooting team when you look right now at Kansas State.
KU by three, here in the final 2 minutes of the first half. Over to go for Clemente. Screen for Pullen, and Kelly called for the walk.
He lifted his pivot foot, came to Connecticut, a big-time reputation on a high school ranks in New York City. Never was able to get comfortable. Sometimes a change is good for everybody.
Judge back in. Samuels will come back out. They don't want him to pick up foul number three.
Kansas State will take on free throw shooting here. 263rd in free throw percentage.
Well, we saw that cost Texas in the game against Baylor today.
Of course, a lot of teams are.
Look at the size. Just Aldrich too big as he is fouled by Pullen. That'll be number two on Jacob Pullen. Got an NBA doubleheader for you tomorrow. The Sunday NBA showcase. It begins at 1 o'clock Eastern time. Denver taking on San Antonio, and then at 3:30 Eastern, one of the great rivalries there's ever been in professional basketball. It'll be the Lakers and the Celtics. Coverage begins at 12:30 Eastern with the GMC NBA countdown.
Man, my buddy's going to be out there in San Antonio. You're working
That's
extra
me.
Overtime.
That's right.
I want to be your agent, man. Get a little piece of the action. All that double time. Wow.
Good to see another Hall. Got a Hall of Famer in you tonight, a Hall of Famer in Hubie Brown with me tomorrow. It's a pretty good weekend for me, huh?
Well, New Jersey guys.
That's right.
Disciples of Howard Garfinkel, the Super Garf, gave us our opportunity.
Marcus Morris, another rebound, is ninth, but he's missed two or three gimmies around the rim. Pullen defended by Morningstar.
They're going to get some screens for Pullen. Got to get that jump shot going.
Aldrich steps out and he's calling for the foul. That'll be number two on the big fella.
Yeah, you don't want to see the big fella commit a foul like that. 45 feet from the goal, stepping out, trying to hedge.
I'll tell you, Dick, this place is a sea of purple with the exception of one row of seats just to our right behind the Kansas bench where you see KU blue. But everything else, it's purple top to bottom. These are the bravest people in the state of Kansas right now.
They had a lot to be proud of, though, I'll tell you that. That program, unbelievable. What Roy Williams did there, you think about averaging 28 wins a year while he was there as a coach.
Judge with a rebound and a putback.
There's that offensive rebound. And Bill Self told us before the game, they could flat out go get it off the glass. Judge says, judge me, man, judge me.
Nine offensive rebounds for K-State.
That means you're playing aggressive basketball.
Collins, the floater goes from the baseline.
He just beat you with super body strength.
And look at Pullen pushing it to the other end, fouled on the floor, says Duke Edsel, as we check out really the best weapon K-State's had in this game so far. That's the offensive rebound.
Yeah, here they go up on the glass again. Judge is going to go up there, keeps the ball alive, spins against the conversion. You know, you mentioned Duke Edsel. His brother is Randy Edsel, the coach at Connecticut. Football, he did a phenomenal job there with the Huskers.
Sure did. By the way, Dick, Markieff Morris is back in the game. Remember, limped off with what looked like kind of a twisted left ankle a little bit earlier. He's back in the game. Aldrich has two fouls. He's gone to the bench.
That's nice when you can go back and forth in your bench with quality players, yeah. Everybody that comes off. And what even makes it more interesting and makes you so competitive, every day in practice, practice is special. I mean, they got guys sitting out now, Mario Little, Travis Rutherford. These are good players who've redshirted because they're so deep.
Now, one of the elite programs in America has always been that way, recruit from all over the country. When you have a coach like Bill Self and a tradition like Kansas has, you're going to be up there every single year.
And they got that rock chalk Jayhawk chant right here, the Octagon of Doom.
Timeout, KU. We'll step aside. Got a good one going. The Jayhawks up by a deuce. Back here with Bramlage, Dan Schulman, Dick Vitale, Airman Andrews. Here's what's going on for K-State this season. Off to their best start in over 15 years at 13-1. Moved into the top 10 in the rankings. Remember, picked up the big win over then number one, Texas. And now they're trying to knock off Kansas, which is currently number two. It's not often you get two opportunities in 2 weeks to play and beat the top two teams in the country.
Well, sandwich game, they lost to Oklahoma State.
Yep,
Travis Ford, good quality basketball team. Life in the Big 12, not easy. You better come to play. Texas Tech certainly has improved.
Zone look here.
Had to go to a zone.
Collins from the wing. Way short on the three. The Wildcats looking to tie or take the lead. Magruder, and he is fouled by Tyshawn Taylor.
Magruder gives him a real lift off the bench. He's got four consecutive games of double figures. Hit some big threes in that win against Baylor.
Just a freshman, and Dick, it was his improvement at the defensive end that has gotten him more playing time. They know he can do it at this end of the floor. Tyrell Reed back in for KU.
Kansas State going for his third straight 20-win season under Frank Martin. Went to the NCAAs in 2008. Beat USC in a first round.
Great fact here. Nobody has taken more free throws in the country this year than Kansas State, but they've only gotten to the line three times tonight. It's not that they're not playing hard. It's not that they're not going to the rim. It just hasn't translated into free throw attempts.
Well, you know what? It's also good defense. Good teams don't foul. Teams like, for example, at Kansas, they're not going to put you on the line to give you easies. Last year they went to the NIT. This year looks like they'll be a lock to the NCAA. So good basketball teams defensively don't foul. I mean, Bobby Knight had those great teams in Indiana. They didn't foul. They played defense the right way. Positioning, beating you to spots.
Well, we've talked about it before. Bo Ryan up at Wisconsin, his teams year after year commit just about the fewest fouls in the country.
And that's a big asset. They're sitting in the zone. He told me we haven't played a lot of zone this year, but we're going to use the zone here.
Just a couple of seconds difference between the game clock and shot clock. Trent Martin is on the court right now. He is 3 feet, 4 feet out onto the court as the game is going on. Nice look inside. Shot clock violation. And K-State will get a chance for the last shot and maybe a lead going into halftime.
It's been a good defensive battle, I'll tell you that.
Well, coming into the week, Kentucky was number one. Of course, the loss Tuesday night to South Carolina is going to knock them out of there. So if Kansas wins tonight, you've got to believe they will become number one, which they were for the first 9 weeks this season. If Kansas loses tonight, could Villanova become number one for the first time ever?
Okay, Villanova or Syracuse could be up there. Syracuse had a close win today. Villanova's got the terrific backcourt, very explosive basketball team. Jay Wright's did a phenomenal job. It's not about who's number one now, though. Yeah. The one beauty of college basketball, it's about being number one down there at the big, big arena, the Lucas Stadium down in Indianapolis. And I'll also celebrate when Peyton Manning brings him back home with that Super Bowl trophy.
All
27-21. 27-21.
Colts?
Colts are going to win it.
Book it. Done.
Peyton Manning, are you kidding me? The guy's an incredible winner.
Poland's got a couple of seconds. Midcourt shot. And the first half will come to a close. Close throughout with Kansas leading Kansas State on the road in a hostile environment by a single point. Airman Andrews is with KU coach Bill Self.
Coach, the last two timeouts, you've been quite fired up. What's been frustrating you?
Well, we've actually played pretty good, but we missed so many bunnies. We missed our free throws. And and they killed us on the offensive glass. That's the thing that disappoints me the most. We got to compete harder on the boards.
How do you counter that in the second half, what they're doing on the offensive glass?
Well, I think, you know, some of it's technique, but a lot of us just want to, and we just got to want it a little bit more.
All right, thanks, Coach.
All right, Aaron, thank you. We're at the half, 31-30 KU at halftime of ESPN Saturday Primetime presented by DirecTV. Time now for the UPS Halftime Report. It's coming up next with Reese and the Gang.
Welcome to halftime at Bramlage Coliseum, everybody. We got some...
Welcome back to ESPN Saturday Night Primetime, presented by DirecTV. Look at this place. Manhattan, Kansas, Bramlage Coliseum, the Octagon of Doom. It hasn't quite been doom so far for Kansas. They're up a point toward the second half. And hi again, everybody, Dan Showman and Dick Vitale. What are some keys for the second half?
Well, I think one of the keys, certainly the Kansas State we talked about in the first half, their guards are going to have to start making shots. Clemente and Poland have not shot the ball well. On the other side, you look inside. Aldridge getting touches inside has been effective. They got to keep going inside to Aldridge. And I thought another key, Dan, was the fact that Kansas kept Kansas State off the free throw line.
Yeah.
They lead the nation in free throw attempts during the course of the season, and they're 3-for-5 here in the first half.
Sherrod Collins just 2-for-7, 4 points. He can take over a game as well. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Dan had a chance to check in with Frank Martin coming out of half. He loves the fight in his team. The fact they were able to settle themselves down in that first half, but he didn't like some of the shot selection by his guys as well. What did he want to see adjusted here in the second half? His bigs. He said they can't turn it over as much. And like Dickie V mentioned, points in the paint. Kansas State, 10. Kansas, 20 with that. Something Frank Martin wasn't happy about.
I'll tell you, Aaron, the one thing I liked what Frank Martin said to me before the game, we're not about here to play them tough and play them close. We have to win. It's our home floor, and we got to get respectability by proving we can win against great teams.
Clemente's floater won't go to start the second half, and back come the Jayhawks. The leading scorer in the game is Cole Aldridge with 10. The leading scorer for K-State, Jacob Pullen, with 7, but he and Clemente again combined to make just 4 of 15 shots in the first half.
You know, Judge came off the bench, went 3-for-3 was a big help.
They got it into Aldridge. He lost the handle. Kicks it out to Morningstar. Aldridge, boy, if he's going to hit that, K-State's going to have some problems because that's a tough shot.
That was a big-time play. Yeah. Spinning to the baseline, fading away. He's got great touch for a big player. He is so skilled for a post player.
Averages 11.3. He's just gone past that. He's got a dozen right now.
He's a real breed. You don't see many. He's like almost zoning in a 3-second area, Aldridge.
Kelly. Offensive rebound, Dominique Sutton.
That's the area for himself. Darren, how he's so concerned. You got to want the basketball. You got to have that hunger. You got to treat it like it's your last meal, man. You got to go after that ball like Moses Malone used to do.
Xavier Henry looking in for Aldridge. They're going right back into the big guy. Good defense by Cologne. Marcus Morris on the weak side for the putback.
Morris, one of the most improved players in the Big 12, getting better and better with minutes, getting quality time. See, they're almost like zoning inside with no post presence.
Bad pass by Kelly, and an intentional foul is called on Denny Clemente. It'll be 2 and the ball for KU.
Bill Self's a master communicator. As a look at Frank Martin, worked from the Shaky Rodriguez, who was a head coach at Miami Senior, now coaching at Club High School, where Luis Colon played.
The Morningstar knocks down the first. Just a bad sequence of events. Kelly telegraphed the pass. Clemente reached out and grabbed Morningstar. A couple of points and the ball now for the Jayhawks.
Could be a 4-point or 5-point play.
Yeah, no question. The crowd has been in the game all night long. A lot of lead changes back and forth in the first half. This is about as big a lead, I think, as we have had in this game.
You got to avoid those spurts that Kansas could put on you. You got to keep them away from getting that spurt. We saw Memphis do a great job,
yeah,
controlling tempo, but ultimately Kansas was able to get that win.
One reason why Collins has been quiet, Dominique Sutton, the best defender for K-State, has had him tonight, and that's Sutton coming up with a loose ball. K-State ball.
Sutton originally committed to Wake Forest, changed his mind, and committed to Wake Forest as a sophomore in high school. He's about in the Raleigh-Durham area. Also was recruited by Kansas, by the Jayhawks.
Tyshawn Taylor checks in here early in the second half for Kansas as Xavier Henry goes out, and the freshman who is so talented, but he has been quiet tonight. Henry, just 2 points and one rebound. Pull in, and Aldridge brings down another rebound.
He is so impressive when you look at Aldridge. He really is. Such a rare breed, as I said. You don't get those 7 foot low post guys that often.
Morningstar using the screen from Aldridge, knocks down the three, and this is the biggest lead of the game for Kansas. Frank Martin calls timeout.
That's a good timeout right there. An excellent timeout. They needed it badly.
KU's gone from up one to up eight here early in the second half.
GMC, we are professional grade.
And we're back here in Manhattan, Kansas, where all of a sudden KU has gone out to an 8-point lead. Frank Martin uses a timeout, makes a couple of subs. Octavius Irving is into the game. Clemente's gone to the bench. And let's keep an eye on 32 and White with the ball. Jamar Samuels, so good, but in foul trouble in the first half. Missed shot by Judge, and Aldridge could not save it. It'll be K-State ball as we check in with Aaron.
Dan, and in that last timeout, Frank Martin obviously very upset with his team, but kind of interesting. Denny Clemente had to walk away and was away from the huddle for quite some time. I couldn't tell if he had words with one of his teammates or one of the coaches, but he wasn't really involved in that huddle. Also, Luis Colon, he was also frustrated, kind of clapping his hands together, even slammed down the chair when he sat down. So frustration starting to boil over here for Kansas State.
Well, always intense on the K-State sideline because of what Frank Martin brings to the table, Dick, and a lot of times the players take on the personality of the coach, so there's going to be a lot of emotion in that huddle.
Yeah, a lot of intensity, a lot of frustration because the build-up of the game day crew here, people all pumped up. The Octagon of Doom right now, a little bit quiet. Yeah. They have quieted them down. You know, Kansas quieted a lot of people down. They think about it, this self needs 5 wins for 400. They need 11 Kansas to reach the 2,000 mark.
Yourself, of course, taking Tulsa, Illinois to the Elite Eight and then took Kansas all the way to the national championship, so he's had success everywhere that he's been.
You know, Kansas went 5 straight points after the intentional foul and on 9-2 here in the second half as they zoned right there in that possession.
Yeah, that was a big play, a real turning point here early in the second half. Marcus Morris is called for the foul. Number two on Morris, who's already got 9 points, 10 rebounds tonight. And it'll be K-State ball.
You don't have to be a genius to figure this out and go to Harvard. I mean, it's very simple. Kansas State cannot win unless Clemente and Pullen get going. Clemente's on the sideline right now. They're going to get him back on the floor, and he's going to get a fire. He had 44 last year against Texas.
Right on cue, Jacob Pullen knocks it down, and he's into double figures. Now they're calling it a long two. So 9 points on the night for Pullen.
Your stars have to deliver. Yeah. When you play quality competition, your stars can't go in a funk.
Kansas, one of the things they focused on in shoot-around today, ball movement. Reverse it from side to side multiple times, move the defense. Tough turnaround, Marcus Morris.
I tell you, I can't get over the unbelievable improvement on Morris. I mean, that was a tough shot. That was like a big-time post play. That's almost like you're going to see tomorrow with Tim Duncan down in the box.
Taylor with a steal, but he steps out of bounds. And we've got a timeout on the floor. Marcus Morris has gone from being a complimentary player to a star in the making right now for Kansas. Dickey's already got a double-double tonight.
Now watch him right here with that spin move on the baseline. The little fadeaway J. Count it. I know about
The Lakers and Celtics tomorrow at a game two of ABC's NBA Showcase. And to Boston and L.A. fans, you can now get all the latest news on the teams you love. The power of ESPN is now covering the Boston and L.A. sports scenes at ESPNBoston.com and ESPNLosAngeles.com.
I will go on record saying Kobe Bryant is as tough as a pro athlete as you'll ever be. He plays hurt. Yeah. He never wants off. He's like Cal Ripken. He just keeps going and going and going, producing an absolute genuine, sensational superstar.
And on the verge right of passing Jerry West is the Lakers' all-time franchise scoring leader. Air ball by Irving. Rebound Judge, stripped away by Morningstar.
Good job by Morningstar. That deflection.
And just led Marcus Morris a little bit too far. Bill Self up off his seat to say, settle down, everybody, settle down.
And a combination inside when you look at Aldridge and Morris, they've combined for 23 points and 17 rebounds.
Clemente back into the game for Kansas State, 2 for 10, 5 points on the night. Now Pullen is the better shooter, but Clemente is still a force, and he is averaging on the season almost 15 points per game. They need some production.
He had 44, as I said last year against Texas. So it tells you he's really, really capable.
Well, let's give some credit to Tyshawn Taylor, who's defending him right now. Judge, little two-man game, and Aldridge swaps it away. Pullen. Offensive rebound of Magruder. That's the 13th offensive rebound by Kansas State.
Pulling shot that from Lawrence, Kansas. Ooh. He's way out of his range.
Magruder takes the handoff.
Magruder very capable of shooting the three. Made some big ones in a win over Baylor.
Clemente off a screen, defended by Collins.
They've done a great job keeping him from getting to the rack.
Baseline and a foul. Clemente really, heading to the line.
He does a great job with his floaters and attacking off the bounce. You take a look at Aldridge inside. Great rejection. Perfect timing. Any doubt that he's going to make a lot of cash?
Oh. Second of the Big 12 in the blocks next to Epe Udo at Baylor. Big win for Baylor down in Austin today, beating Texas in an overtime game. Aldridge in the top 10 in the country in block shots.
Carter had a great game for Baylor.
Marcus Morris back in for Kansas. As brother Marcus, Markeith back in as brother Marcus comes out. I'd like you to put forward a motion that anybody who recruits identical twins, it should be immediately an NCAA violation.
I know, it drives us nuts. I'll let you handle that.
Yeah.
Hey, the Big 12 has 11 of its 12 teams with at least 12 wins. And tonight, Colorado's going for their 12th at Iowa State. That's amazing.
All right, so let me ask you this. Last year, everybody said Big East is the best conference. This year, a lot of people say the Big East is the best conference. The ACC, of course, gets a lot of acclaim. What about the Big 12?
Well, the Big 12 certainly right up there in the conversation, but I think the Big East is the best. Again, another example, the Hoyas beating Duke last week, Connecticut beating Texas.
Aldridge fouled from behind, and he'll shoot a couple as we show you the Big 12 standings. If Kansas State wants to have a realistic chance of winning this league in the regular season, they've got to win this game tonight. KU has won the last 5 regular season titles, 3 of them outright.
I tell you right now, my VBDI, Kansas in the tournament, Texas in the tournament, Kansas State, Missouri, Oklahoma State, Baylor, Texas State, they got 7 already.
Wow.
Possibly for more. I mean, the conference is very strong.
Third foul on Wally Judge. He's out. Curtis Kelly back in.
But you know what? I don't want to hear this bias. I get all kinds of comments, you know, on Twitter, people writing, sending notes, all this jazz. They always have this East Coast bias. It's not East Coast bias. The facts are the facts.
Right.
Georgetown beats Duke. That's a fact. Connecticut beats Texas. That's a fact. I mean, those are teams in the middle of the pack in the Big East.
You've got quality win bias. You're biased towards teams that actually win big games, right?
Exactly. We'll give love to whoever deserves love, man.
How about Syracuse? They were down 14 to Georgetown a few days ago, beat them. They were down 18 in the first half at DePaul and came back and won that game today. Clemente, yes!
That's the floater I was talking about. He does a great job getting in the lane, shooting that floating layup. Mr. Clemente, not Roberto, this is Denny. And that's Clemente with the floater. I used to love Roberto. Oh, I'm a baseball fanatic.
Yeah, outstanding career with a Pittsburgh Hall of Fame career. And when he died in the plane crash, New Year's Eve Day, 1972, exactly 3,000 hits. He picked up his last hit that season was number 3,000. And a worthy Hall of Famer. One of the, you talk about a guy that hit, throw, run, he could do everything.
Right fielder, just like Al Kaline. They were unbelievable. He wears number 21 like his second cousin.
That's right. So many young baseball players wear number 21 in honor and memory of Roberto Clemente. And Danny Clemente wears 21 in honor of his second cousin as well.
They're back in the game. Back in the game. The crowd wants to get in it. They said, please get us to the 4-minute mark with a chance to win. They have really contained Sherron Collins. They have kept him under wraps.
Pulling on him now. Sutton has had it much of the night as well. Collins just 4 points.
Pulling's been going on a great deal too, and that may be affecting him offensively.
Aldrich spins around Kelly, but he missed it. Kansas State ball.
That was a great drop step and a spin move. Your buddy you're working with tomorrow, UD Brown, one of the greatest teachers of post moves. I know he has to like watching this kid Aldrich.
Aldrich close to 7 feet, about 245 pounds out of Bloomington, Minnesota, junior preseason All-America candidate. And tonight, 13 points and 7 rebounds. Kelly misses the long two. Rebound Markeith Morris. We'll make sure he hangs on to that basketball in traffic.
And very strong on that baseline. One of the best baselines in America when you look at Kansas.
Taylor with a burst of speed, and it bounces off the rim.
This place would rock if Mr. Poulin would pull up and drain a three.
Now it's hard to hear the whistle. We've got a foul. That was before that drive by Kelly. The foul going on Markeith Morris. Looking for an explanation now from one of the officials, Paul Jansen, as Marcus comes back in and Cole Aldrich will come out.
I look at that Kansas bench. I see Danny Manning, one of the greatest ever to play. In fact, in my book, when I rate the top players in my 30 years, he's in the top five. He was so versatile.
Yep.
And people can help me raise some cash for the V Foundation. All my proceeds go there. Get my book, go to DickVitaleOnline.com.
Danny Manning, who led Kansas to the national championship in 1988. Samuels knocks down a jumper. K-State within three. Timeout, KU.
Samuels gives him that lift.
Number two, Kansas has won 25 of the last 26 times they have come to Manhattan. But here in the Octagon of Doom tonight, they get in the battle for number 13. More basketball coming your way. It's Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, with a doubleheader. It begins at 7 Eastern on a Monday night. Connecticut and Louisville. And then at 9 Eastern, another Big 12 battle. Texas and Oklahoma State. Texas will try to right the ship after the home court overtime loss to Baylor earlier today.
Bob Huggins got his first win against Louisville tonight. Several NBA guys coaching right now. Doug West at Villanova, Rod Strickland, Kentucky, Scotty Burrell, Quinnipiac, Walker McCarty at Louisville, Milt Wagner's at UTEP, Steve Henson, former Kansas State player at UNLV, Ron Kruger.
And Dick, during this timeout, apparently the officials have given Kansas's bench a warning for being a little bit too rowdy. And the emotion again has been running at a fever pitch since this game began because of the proximity of the two schools. This is one of the few times they've both been ranked this highly. That's not KU's fault, but K-State is doing it much better these days. Just the atmosphere in here, it's been an emotional night.
Well, you know, Kansas State has closed the gap talent-wise. Their talent level has not been at the level to compete with Kansas, so there's really been no rivalry. It's been domination. Taylor, a very key player. If they're going to cut the Nets down and win a national title, he has got to get really into the mix. I give him that big guard play that he's capable of. He's a defender. He's got size, good passer.
Markeith Morris a little strong. Markeith Morris over the back.
For the momentum switch. Uncle Mo has switched over to the Wildcats.
Let's look at the last timeout. Remember we told you a warning was given to KU's bench. As one of the officials, Paul Jansen, talks with Joe Dooley, Curtis Townsend, two of the assistants on the Kansas bench, about everybody just staying under control right now. Number three out of Markeith Morris. So Cole Aldrich back in. He was out only 38 seconds. The two big guys for Kansas, Cole Aldrich and Marcus Morris, have combined for 24 points and 17 rebounds.
You know, when Frank Morton made that call and that timeout and took Clemente out, then he's brought him back in, they'll change basketball team.
Kelly. What an answer at the other end by the All-America candidate, Sherrod Collins.
He's been doing that his entire career. He has been such a big difference maker in games, making big shots. Had to make some big shots to beat Cornell the whole level off
that
hole.
Right. Good Cornell team that took KU down to the wire. And we're going to have a hold on Marcus Morris. That will be his third. So each of the Morris twins now with three fouls, and K-State right back in it.
Mike Hamm with a SportsCenter right now. It was the first time he was named to the Pro Bowl, but Bryant McKinney won't be playing. The Minnesota offensive tackle has been dismissed from the NFC squad after missing practice on both Friday and Saturday. The Longhorns, they're in a tailspin. They've now lost three of four after losing in overtime to Baylor. The Bears tweeted Carter got a season high with 27. Next SportsCenter right after the X Games at 11 Eastern.
All right, Mike, thank you, and welcome back to a sold-out and rowdy Bramlage Coliseum Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. What a game. Kansas 45, Kansas State 42, football coach Bill Snyder. And how about Darren Sproles, running back, great returner, former K-State star. Pullen back within one.
Right now they're shooting 3-for-11 from the three. Pullen and Clemente starting to give them point production.
Little 1-2-2 trap. They got a turnover, and they're looking for the lead.
Half-court trap. Great drive by Pullen.
Back-to-back buckets by Jacob Pullen, and K-State has the lead back.
I credit that guy right there, Frank Morton, with the timeout, getting Clemente out, a little bit upset with the way they were playing, brings him back, and they've gotten the spark from their guards. There's a look at right now, Pullen, they're jumping, they're going to watch a change of direction, and then he lays it with the left hand up on the glass. They got this place rocking, baby, it's electric, they're on a lemon juice spurt right now. I like the job Martin does. He has earned the right to be on his sideline. It didn't come easy. A lot of people didn't think he belonged here.
Yeah. But he says, you know what? Coaches are supposed to be of a certain mold, of a certain type. He says, you know what? I'm not like that, but I am who I am. And if you ask him what he likes the most about his team, he says one word, unity. This is a very together group that he's got right now.
Also toughness.
Yeah.
They have a certain amount of toughness and mentality. That's so special. A little half-court trap again.
Jeff Withey came to the game for Kansas just for that last 10 or 15 seconds. Bill Self took him right back out, and Marcus Morris is back in with three fouls.
You got to play him with three fouls. You're on the road. You got to flash Aldrich to the post area.
Zone for K-State.
Said he was going to play some zone. Little turnover against the zone.
Clemente.
Score the basket. What a great on-lip pass. That little coaching maneuver, going to the half-court trap, using versatility, then going to the zone. What a great catch. There's definitely the interference. And at home now, Kansas would have won 54 in a row, the longest home streak in America.
Collins a miss. Rebound Clemente.
He is so quick.
Samuels follows it up.
Is that offensive rebounding again? One of their great strengths. They're going to beat a lot of people up on that glass.
Yep.
Like Georgetown did years ago. And John Thompson brought a ball up on the glass, and that was their offense, really.
Good decision here, Dick, to calm it down and run their offense a little bit.
Get some execution.
Pulling for three.
Got it to the right guy. He said he has to make shots. They're waving it off.
They are waving it off. A screen, an illegal screen called on Kelly, nullifies the basket. That little hip check on Sherrod Collins. Good call.
Absolutely a good call. You cannot move. Took away the great chance and good efficiency. They're running a down screen.
Wow, what a big call that is. And the correct call, but what a big play that is.
They ran that vertical screen, got him down, popped it up. Oh, that could be a big play.
1-2-2, slowing down KU again.
Using Sanders up at the point of it with great size. Got it back in the zone. Scrapping out of the zone.
Out of bounds, but off Kelly, says Duke Etzel. KU retains the ball with 16 on the clock. Well, a record crowd for game day this morning, and Dick, maybe a record decibel level for any game that we've done this year.
It is loud, buddy. Tough to hear you here. Oh, he can't foul him there. He grabbed him.
Pullen called for the foul, number 3. On the K-State star, and he gives Duke Etzel a little pat on the rump after that call.
I love Frank Martin's intensity and emotion. He's got a lot of Bob Huggins on that sideline.
He really does. And, of course, Huggins is a guy that Frank Martin refers to as his mentor, his big brother, a guy that he coached alongside, coached under, and inherited this job from after Huggins went back to Morgantown.
Most of the year they play man-to-man, but they're using that zone right here.
Marcus Morris, no. Rebound, Magruder.
Tough shot. Like the run out of that zone. You got good lanes.
Kelly.
Nice pass. Good interior passing.
Very going unselfish. To the line is Samuels.
I think a very unselfish team as well. Want to share the basketball. They are unified. They got the crowd support. A lot of passionate fans.
Dick, number 3 on Cole Aldrich. So he's got 3. Marcus Morris has 3. Markeith Morris has 3. And Xavier Henry has just walked right in front of us to the scorer's table to check in.
He has really had limited minutes here tonight. Yep. Free throw line can be big. Remember, Kansas State, not a good free throw shooting team. But they'll be focused tonight. Could be a little different.
Henry in for Taylor.
So much of free throw shooting comes down to focus, man. Focus, concentrate. Pullen said that when he was a kid, his brothers and sisters on a playground used to scream and yell. So when he went to the line with 8 seconds left against Baylor, and they were screaming and yelling, he said it wasn't as tough as my brothers and sisters.
That's good training.
And he made a bunk and they won the game.
Samuels 1-of-2, K-State by 4.
Boy, Uncle Mo has swung the way of Kansas State.
Deep three by Collins. Got it. Boy, there are few players in America who can make a big shot at a big moment as well as Collins. And now Jacob Pullen is down and injured behind the play.
Randy Etzel jumping in the face of Samuels. He's starting to get in the face of some of the Kansas players. It's getting a little bit heated on the court. It's getting a little bit heated. Words are being exchanged. Siobhan Collins said, come on, calm down, Kelly. Puts his arm around him. Calm down, let's play basketball. Let's enjoy the moment and play basketball. I like what Collins is doing.
Great job of sportsmanship on both sides. Now we'll have to get a look back, see if we get a replay, and see exactly what happened to Jacob Pullen.
I did not see that play, Dan.
Keep an eye on 0 in white. Oh, and right there, it was his own man. Ran into his own man in Samuels. Inadvertent elbow by his teammate that knocked Pullen down. Samuels got bumped a little bit by Aldrich and wound up injuring his teammate.
They certainly need him on the floor down the stretch.
Made some big shots in the second half, Pullen has. Right there.
I like the way Sharon Collins took charge, not only making the big shot, but took charge with all the players on the floor as well. Refs are going to the monitor. They want to see if anything transpired in that scenario. I don't think they're going to find anything there at all.
No, when there's a situation like this, sometimes they can look just to make sure there was no deliberate elbow or a punch thrown, that there was nothing that constitutes a fight. It was actually, I said Aldrich, it was Marcus Morris who got tangled up with Samuels, but it was Samuels who made contact with Pullen, and that's what Duke Etzel is saying. Everything's okay. We can get back to basketball.
A lot of intensity. You could almost feel it here coming through us.
Can you ever?
You can really feel it. That's the beauty of college basketball. The passion, the spirit, the enthusiasm. You got rivalries going at it. It's really great. I tell you, 30 years, 30 plus years I'm doing this, and I still get goosebumps, man. I still get the adrenaline flying. It's unbelievable just to be part of this. Kids are playing with their hearts, man, playing with passion, playing for that jersey they represent.
Poland looks okay as he sits on the bench. Dominique Sutton has come back in for him. And we'll see how long Poland is out of this game. Less than 9 minutes to go.
See, Clemente should have a little bit too much speed for him up the top. I would get the ball to Clemente. Try to get him one-on-one. Utilize that driving ability. Yes, stepping out. And Aldridge.
Remember, Aldridge playing with three. Good reach into by Morningstar. Causes the turnover. Here comes Sharon Collins. Count the basket, and Kansas goes back on top.
And they're back on top one. Two great plays by Sharon Collins. Hits the big three, and there's the drive using the left hand.
And here he comes, pulling right back into the game. Magruder out.
He's one of those kind of players that just doesn't allow you to lose. He finds a way to win.
Collins?
Yeah.
Yes.
Certain players have them. Peyton Manning has it. Derek Jeter has it. Tim Tebow has it.
Well, you talked about the Cornell game, and people may be saying, well, Cornell, big deal. But first of all, Cornell is a terrific team. They were leading most of the way at Kansas in Lawrence before Collins exploded late, scored 33 points, and led them to a five-point win. Aldridge, what a rejection.
That was a big-time block right there. I mean, that was a terrific timing.
And now the lob inside for Marcus Morris results in a foul on Jamar Samuels, number three on him.
Watch the great timing here. He's got three fouls. He stays on the ground. He waits until he goes up offensively. And there he is with a good angle using a right hand.
Wow. Crowd was booing, but that was a beautiful block.
Oh,
there was no
legitimate
body contact at all. Lonely Judge into the game, and now for K-State.
Ball's in the hands of Collins. He has scored their last 7 points. He's so strong. Stepping out of that screen. A little switch. Made him pick up the dribble. Good spacing by Bill Self's club.
Morris needs some help. Now he's going to do it himself. Henry. Henry had it, got it again. Puts up the jumper and hits it. Big time sequence for the freshman, Xavier Henry.
I tell you, the diaper dandy responded there. He has really been quiet in Big 12 action.
Uh-oh.
That's four. That's four.
Paul Aldridge, number four.
I would go right at him. You got to attack him to try to get him to be an assistant coach.
Well, that's only going to fire people up in this building even more, and they don't need any extra reasons to get fired up. Frank Martin's fired up. Everybody in purple's fired up tonight, and we got a good one here at K-State.
And you're fired up.
Everybody! All right. When you look at the future of your business, what do you see? Is the glass half empty or half full?
Well, with UPS, you can eliminate warehouses, streamline your supply chain, and even reach new global markets.
So your business is more adaptable,
more efficient, and more profitable. Hey, the opportunities are out there. Seize them with UPS.
Is anybody else thirsty?
Exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV. To get the most out of your high-def TV, you gotta hook it up to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. And in part by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance.
Well, Dick, as we welcome everybody back to Manhattan, Kansas, Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. 3-point lead for Kansas, 7:28 to go. And Cole Aldridge just picked up foul number four. How does that change things?
Well, put it down. 7:52 on the clock. They're plus three, and he's got four. I think you got to be in attacking mode if you're right now Kansas State, and you got to go challenge the big fella. You got to try to get him out of this game.
And he's going to be sitting down on the bench right now. Markeith Morris is going to come back in along with his twin brother, Marcus.
I agree with that move by Bill Self. As long as you got the lead, you can take him out. You know, it's amazing. Kansas has had just three players lead the team and score in an average 20-plus games points since the 88 championship. You got Manning, Paul Pierce averaged 20 a game, and Wayne Simeon.
at the line for Kansas State, Wally Judge. You talk about your hometown bounce.
They needed that bounce. 253rd in the nation on a free throw line. Yet they lead the nation in free throws attempted.
In getting there, that's right.
Because of their efforts.
They bounce down a couple of huge free throws. 1-point game.
They're going to look for that pressure here.
Sutton picking up Collins.
Sutton has that great size. He can challenge him. They're going to double up, trying to get the ball out of his hands. They're going to double him up. I think it's a good move, trying to get the ball away from him. Let somebody else beat you.
It bounces back to Collins, pulling on it.
I would let somebody else beat me. I would allow this guy to beat me.
They'll do it again.
He's too good.
Nearly stolen. Henry. Morris. Collins, the cutter, couldn't handle the pass.
Watch this quickness with the ball. Are you serious? What's he trying to get? Degree of difficulty, five?
And a foul on Marcus Morris, number 4 on him.
Number 22, Marcus Morris is his
That was almost an acrobatic shot by Clemente. A little bit out of control, but he's got that superb quickness. He's got that attacking style, and that's one of the reasons they go to the free throw line so often.
Samuels at the line.
I like him, Dan. I love Samuels.
Now, Dick, what about this? Here comes Tyshawn Taylor. Marcus Morris out. Smaller lineup. Xavier Henry slides to the four. And the two real big-time inside players for Kansas are on the bench.
Kid that can make some shots for Kansas has got to step up his morning star.
Rebound to Henry. Tie game under 7 to play. KU in foul trouble.
Here's what you would expect right now. With the two studs on the sideline, that Xavier Henry would step up. He's such a good athlete.
Remember, for Henry, this might be the first time in his life he has seen an environment like this. Collins, of course, has seen it all.
Are you serious? He can play for me any day of the week. He is a winner, man. He's a flat-out winner.
10 of his 14 here in the second half. Pull in.
Up in the Windy City, too. He says, Sharon, we're playing for bragging rights, baby. We're playing for bragging rights.
Not this time for Collins.
We're playing for little pride. Proviso East against Crane High School.
Pullen, nice pass.
Oh, Jam City. My friend, you get paid for this. Are you serious?
As good as it gets. The two Chicago guards going at it. First, Sharon Collins with a three.
And Sharon shooting the long arching three. And then is his buddy right there. Is the bullet from out of Proviso East. And Doc Rivers jumps out of his seat. That's my guy. Because he was from the same high school. And there's the dump inside.
You know what Frank Martin said to us this morning? We don't need anybody to be a hero tonight. We just need to play. Pullen could have tried to take that ball to the rim, give his team the lead, blow the roof off this joint. But he gave it up to a wide open Samuels. A terrific decision by Pullen. K-State leads as we say hello again to Aaron Andrews.
And Dan, we asked Frank Martin about that when we were talking about the environment here tonight. And I asked Bill Self that very question. How do you handle this environment? And he said, I want my guys to soak this up. I want them to enjoy it. We could be playing shirts and skins right now. You think they're really enjoying how loud it is in here right now? Come on.
Listen to the noise, and Bill Self has made the move, Dick. He had to make. Aldrich and Marcus Morris, each with 4 fouls, both of them back into the game.
Well, with 5 minutes on the clock, that was his decision. Getting to the 5-minute mark. There's 3 unbeaten teams in conference play in the BCS conferences, and one of them is Kansas, along with Michigan State and Villanova.
Ball deflected by Pullen, so not a backcourt violation. Shot clock at 10. Marcus Morris, and a block is the call on Wally Judge, who took a real shot.
Tell you one thing, though, if you're Bill Self, you got to be pleased that Morris didn't allow himself to become passive. He played aggressively, even with the fouls.
And it looked like the left elbow of Marcus Morris might have come up and hit Judge in the jaw. Yep.
Judge has given him some good minutes on it, but he and Samuels off the bench.
Number four on Judge. Curtis Kelly's going to check in.
It's going to get down to free throw shooting, Dan. The winner or loser is going to be the team that makes free throws.
Judge out, Kelly in.
Kelly's been really a solid player for them all year. Came the way of Connecticut as a transfer. Clemente came the way of Miami. I guess the message is, if you're unhappy, give us a call. We'll make you happy.
Well, again, you can't overstate the improvement of Marcus Morris in the last couple of weeks. Their leading scorer in conference play, Pulling. And that's going to go on Samuels. He pleads his case, but to no avail. Going to be number four on Jamar Samuels.
Well, he's pleading with his team and his coaching staff. There's only one guy he should have been pleading prior to that, and that's Randy Etzel. This is the only one that counts that made the call. Duke Etzel, Randy's brother.
1-1 now for KU. Aldrich at the line, 73% on the season. Somewhat unorthodox delivery on his shots as he puts the ball way up behind his head, but for a big guy, pretty good percentage.
Some of the keys will be in the game, whether or not Kansas State can get Aldrich to that sideline. He's the one difference maker because of his post ability, his size.
Just over 5 minutes to go here in Manhattan. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV and WinterX 14 coming up next here on ESPN.
See, he's just like zoning in that 3 second area right now.
Morningstar on Clemente. Collins on Pulling. Pulling not getting a touch this possession. Playing off the ball, off on the wing. So Kelly, a tough one, and it goes!
Wow. Kelly, a little bit of Lamar Odom in this game. Yeah. A little bit of Lamar Odom in this game.
Lefty with a lot of length.
Yeah.
Well, some good moves in the paint. Tied again.
This is Mailock's time for the coaches, man. It's Mailock's time. This game is much more important. Any way you cut it, even though it means number one, it's much more important to Kansas State to try to protect the home territory.
Xavier Henry, Dick, just scratching the surface of his ability.
Well, he's one of the great diaper dandies in America, one of the big-time recruits.
Boy, Pullen not even getting a look now, twice in a row. But Dominic Sutton says, I'll take care of it.
A terrific baseline drive. Seen a lot of athleticism. He's gone. Morris is gone.
Marcus Morris has fouled out.
Smart play by Sutton. Four fouls. He's going to attack the basket. Challenges him. Morris right there. Challenges him. Sutton almost initially committed to Wake Forest.
Another big night for Marcus Morris, but KU has lost one of their most important players with better than 4 minutes to go.
That means Xavier Henry has to step up now and be the player they know he can be. He has demonstrated all year long, prior to Big 12 action, that he's a star player.
Markieff Morris will replace Marcus at the power forward spot. Xavier Henry, who played the four briefly tonight, at the three right now. K-State has had some big wins against some top teams in just 2.5 years under Frank Martin. They beat number one less than 2 weeks ago, looking to beat number two here tonight.
Well, the reason I say it's more important to Kansas State in terms of the importance of this game, you're playing at home right now, and you can't allow Kansas to come in here and beat you, especially when you're trying to earn a little respectability, credibility, and want to get to the upper echelon of the conference. You lose this game, your dreams of winning this conference championship are pretty well shattered.
Three-point play, Sutton. One-point lead, K-State.
This is not going to be easy when they go to Lawrence, my friend. We know that. Just ask the other 54 teams in a row that went to the sideline.
Morningstar quiet tonight, knocks down a huge corner three.
Said he had to step up and get an open look, and he gets it and delivers. Again, one of those role players who understands what his role is. Get the open three, make it count.
Here comes pulling around a baseline screen. He's got it. 16 points tonight for pulling the high score in the game. Off to Clemente. And Morningstar called for the foul. They want the basket. They're not going to get it. And it'll be two shots when we come back. Some great guards in this game. The All-America candidate Sherron Collins leading the way for KU. Jacob Pullen doing his thing for K-State. Down to the wire they go.
Mike M with a Sports Center right now, and coming up after the game, it's the Winter X Games. Travis Rice looking to defend his gold medal in snowboard big air. Winter X Games coming up next. Back to Manhattan for a big time finish.
All right, Mike, thank you, but we've got almost 4 minutes to go. Maybe might need a little bit more than that, Dick. You never know the way things are going here. Fear the Beard is one of the slogans here at the building they like to call the Octagon of Doom. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV with Dick Vitale, Aaron Andrews. I'm Dan Shulman, and this has been everything it was advertised to be between these two rivals.
Tell you one thing, Frank Martin's got a role. He's got a great recruiting class coming in, including a kid from New York City, where Curtis Kelly's from, Shane Southwell. They have some great coaches here, man. You think about Jack Gardner and Tex Winter and Cotton Fitzsimmons and Jack Hartman and Lon Kruger, Dana Altman, Bob Huggins. And this Frank Martin, when it's all said and done in his career, is going to be a solid collegiate coach. He really knows how to recruit, and he knows how to communicate.
5 second call.
Great
how
effort.
About that?
Great effort on that defensive end, shutting off any possible outlets.
We've had 11 ties and 12 lead changes in this game. Keep in mind, Marcus Morris of Kansas has fouled out. Cole Aldrich is playing with four, and two Wildcats have four, one of whom is in the game, Jamar Samuels.
Tell you one thing, if it goes to overtime, edge goes to the home team, especially with Morris out and if they can get Aldrich out. See, I don't know why they're not attacking Aldrich. Like right now, he's playing the guy with the ball. Why not put it on the floor and just go right at it? Make him have to play defense. That's it. Take him. I would take him one-on-one right now. Isolate him. There it is.
Go Kelly the with a running jump hook.
Thank you, Mr. Showman. Thank you, Mr. Showman. A little one-on-one maneuver. He's got Lamar Odom, I'm telling you. Versatility.
He took your advice and he made it count. Taylor. And a foul on Kansas State.
Taylor starting to really elevate his game again. Started off this year in a little bit of a slump. Wasn't focused. Has a little one-on-one move. He can't really attack him defensively. So he's playing sort of like very passive on the defensive end.
The foul on Kelly. Two shots coming for Taylor. 70% on the season.
What a career he's having. You think about playing for Bob Hurley and now Bill Self. I think you're getting a little bit of coaching.
Not bad.
You're learning a little bit about the game. This guy, one of the big-time stars right now in the coaching profession.
Well, you talk about coaches who are in the Hall of Fame or putting together Hall of Fame resumes. You give Bill Self 8-10 more years like he's going right now to Kansas, and he's going to be right there.
Well, the numbers he's going to post.
Yep.
I mean, in a bad year, they're going to win 25.
19-1 this year, the only loss at Tennessee. Kansas ball. And that Tennessee game was an incredible game. That was right after the suspensions in Tennessee with six scholarship players, I think, and three walk-ons. Just played such an incredibly emotional game. Got contributions from everybody and really shocked the Jayhawks.
Yeah, it was an emotional night. These Pearls kids were ready to perform and perform so well. I don't care. When you go on the road, you saw it today, Syracuse to Pearl. It is tough. For college basketball, you play on the road. Familiarity is so much of an asset to teams.
On to Collins.
A great team's responding to it. A kid like Collins loves this challenge.
No question.
He loves this challenge.
He's a senior. He's made so many big shots in his 4 years in Lawrence. Lob inside for Markeith Morris. Stripped from behind. Black, no foul call as they go tumbling to the floor.
You talk about physicality.
And Samuels has just fouled out of the game. And we have an injured K-State player. I believe that's Samuels, who's down.
It's holding the back of his head.
That one was cleaned by Samuels. And he hit the back of his head on the court.
I mean, you talk about a sport physically. I mean, the referee at this level is so difficult. Yep. You can almost blow the whistle in every possession.
I'm not sure that Samuels knew that foul was on him until just this moment. Kelly's putting up his hand, I think, as if to say the foul was on me, but the call was definitely initially made on Jamar Samuels.
Samuels. It was made on Samuels.
Yeah, and it's number five on him, and he's going to have to come out as Magruder comes back in, and K-State gets smaller.
That's a big loss. That's a big loss. He's so explosive.
ESPN kicks off Super Bowl week tomorrow when McDonald's presents the 2010 Pro Bowl at 7:20 Eastern. The NFL's top stars are on one stage the Sunday before the Super Bowl. Coverage begins with Sunday NFL Countdown at 5:30 Eastern. Markieff Morris at the line for KU.
Coming down the last 2 minutes, that free throw line so important.
Did we have a lane violation? No, he's got two shots coming. They went in there as if it was one and one, but it was two shots. So Markieff Morris, one more coming. He's 0 for 3 tonight.
0 for 3 on that line, and that could be big. Bill Self told Aaron earlier, we got to make our free throws. Oh, wow. What a bumpy. Great chance now for Kansas State. The octagon of doom could be rocking big time.
Timeout, KSU. Full timeout, says Frank Martin.
What I like about Frank Martin before the game, he said this is not about playing close. It is about winning. It's not about a moral victory. We're not looking for that. You know, somebody teams play Kansas, they say, oh, we could have done this, we should have done this, and we played them tough. That's not what it's about. You got to win.
2 years ago, number two Kansas was here. 2 years ago tonight, let's take a look back at what happened. The wins have been few and far between for K-State against KU, to say the least. Only one of their last 26 here, the one you just saw, that's the only time in the last 26 games here in Manhattan that the home side has won. But they've got a shot tonight. We're tied at 66, 2:15 to go.
Yeah, you can't have a rival, as I said a little bit earlier. 31 in a row they had won, when you consider the fact also in Lawrence as well.
Winter X Games follows us immediately after the conclusion of this game right here on ESPN. Winter X 14 from Aspen. Aaron, what do you got?
Just listening to Kansas's huddle right there, and Bill Self trying to remind his team, let's stay poised, let's stay tough. But Dan, I got to tell you, at the end, he put a big smile on his face and said, come on, this is fun. This is great. We love this atmosphere. We can celebrate in a couple minutes, but I need you to stay poised, and you have to stay tough.
I'll tell you one thing, Aaron, you could say it's fun and it's great when you're 19-1, man. When you're 19-1, it is fun. Right now, challenge Aldridge. Go right at him again. Go right at him.
Clemente, Sutton right into the chest of Aldridge, who stood him up and comes up with the ball and is fouled by Kelly.
Aldridge did a great job to hold his ground right there. Smart play by Kansas State, trying to attack the big guy, but he wouldn't buy it. He played defense. Right now, they're going to challenge him. He just elevates his hands.
Good
like
job.
An umbrella.
Yeah.
Good defensive job by Aldridge.
A lot of big guys, Dick, as you well know, they stand up tall, but then the arms come down, and you get the foul call.
I like the way you demonstrated it.
It's a visual medium, you know.
Let's see what he does on the line now. He's a 73% shooter.
Double bonus both teams the rest of the way. Two shots.
When you've got a combination inside and outside of Collins and Aldridge, and you build a little bit around them, what a foundation you have to build on.
Not only the talent those two guys have, but the experience as well. Collins a senior, Aldridge a junior.
And also the desire to want to win. I mean, that's special. Certain players have great ability to get stats, but they don't know how to win.
Oh, boy. Lane violation. K-State.
That is really a bad. Oh, man. That is just absolutely silly.
And Aldridge does this, not intentionally, but because of his unusual delivery, he'll get some of these sometimes. KU gets the ball back.
KU has gone. They have missed four of the last five free throws.
And they're a good free throw shooting team, at least better than K-State. KU is up at 71%. K-State down around 65%.
They're going to want to get the ball in Collins' hands.
And another foul. This one on Dominique Sutton. Tyshawn Taylor will go to the line for two. Frank Martin, you can see the displeasure on his face. What are you doing?
Well, he got the missed free throw and they don't come up with the rebound. And that's going to frustrate any coach in a one-point game. You're down one in a team that attempting to be the number one team in America. Because Taylor, he strokes that with a lot of confidence.
Well, this is a bad trip down at this end of the floor for K-State. A lane violation, then they can't get the rebound at their end of the floor. And then a foul that was unnecessary, shouldn't have happened, and Taylor knocks down a couple.
Does a great job converting those two. Leading scorer on the USA team under Jamie Dixon, who won the gold in New Zealand. Now, right now, it's big. The right people have to have the basketball. You got to make sure Pullen or Clemente want the right guys to shoot.
Clemente, good show there by Aldridge. Kelly, cross court. 10 to shoot. Pullen misses the three, but they get it back.
He didn't really have a good look for that three. Collins was right in his face.
And a timeout taken by Frank Martin. Now, it's been another eventful week for teams up near the top of the rankings. We've seen a number of them lose this week, including number one Kentucky, who won't be number one after this week, despite an impressive win over Vanderbilt today. Kansas can ascend to the number one spot with a win here tonight. Of course, Texas losing this week, Duke losing today, BYU lost earlier this week. Parity reigns supreme. It's fun.
Well, I think the unpredictability in college basketball is going to make it so special come March Madness. Yes. Which to me, I mean, you could talk Super Bowls, you could talk the World Series. There is nothing like March Madness. For 3 weeks, the way it captivates America. Grandma, grandpa, everybody gets involved.
We got a little January madness here tonight in this building.
Oh, it is madness. Yeah. Possession right now. So big to Kansas State. They got to convert. Doesn't have to be a three.
Fear the beard, Dick. Fear the beard is pulling the guy to take the big shot.
Well, he's certainly one of their top options, but he's got to take a legitimate good shot. Hey, where's that beard?
I'm going to be seeing that in my nightmares.
All right, let's see if they get a screen here. Oh, little matchup right here. I got Taylor playing against Clemente.
Into the final minute. Stolen away. Great defense by Tyshawn Taylor.
He's been really a positive force off that bench. Gives him good size in the guard spot. A little exchange. Come on, a little bit of weave on the outside. He's going to strip switch.
And Taylor turns it over to Magruder. Connects!
Athlete Magruder, very athletic, has been big in the last four games. He's had four consecutive double-doubles. Here he is, the spin in the lane. Ooh, one of those close calls, charge or block.
And a good free throw shooter as well, Magruder, 78% on the season. He gets one to tie. Judge for Magruder, judge in for defense. 1 second between the game clock and shot clock. Tie game, Kansas ball.
Full court pressure defense. You got to try to keep it away right now from Collins. If you're Kansas State, Pullen's going to try and deny him the ball. You don't want Collins to beat you. See, right now he's denying the ball. Pullen's trying to keep the ball away from Kyle.
Bill Self will use his last timeout.
Jacob Pullen was in a denial defense, which I think is outstanding. Smart play. You want to keep the ball out of the hands of Collins.
Now, if you're Kansas, is option number one inside to the big fella Aldrich, or is Collins the guy who takes that big shot?
No, I think you got to go to the interior. Go inside, maybe kick it back out to Collins, but you got to go to the big guy Aldrich.
Quickly, let's go back to the studio. Here's Mike Yan. All right, Mike, thank you. Tie game with 21 seconds to go. Kansas with the ball. K-State with a timeout left. Both teams double bonus. The arrow goes to KU.
That arrow drives me nuts. But right now, you look at the scenario here. Bill Self, who's been in these moments, not bigger than winning the national championship, when it came from behind and a dramatic shot by Mario Chalmers and sent it to overtime.
Frank Martin said for the last 6 months when he walks around Manhattan, people say to him one thing, beat KU. This is the game that matters more, whether they want to admit it or not. The coaching staff and the players, this is the biggest game on their schedule.
Well, Curtis Kelly said that in an article today in the newspaper. He said when he came to visit here, he had not even committed. When he got off the plane, people were saying to him, beat KU. He said, wow. And now he's getting a feeling of what this rivalry and what this intense game is all about.
20 seconds on the shot clock, 21 on the game clock.
He's pleading his case right now with Duke Edsel. I don't know what Pullen's pleading his case.
Tyrell Reed back into the game for the first time in a long time. Another shooter. He's out there with Morningstar and Taylor and Collins. Four guards and Aldrich in the game for Bill Self.
The reason you want a shooter like that, if the ball goes inside and they double up on Aldrich, you bang it right out to the shooter. Here we go, baby. Here we go. Will Kansas beat number one in America? Or will they be rocking here? Alternate possession. You make the good play, Kansas State, and you get penalized.
I'll tell you
that
what.
That rule is a joke.
But what a save by Sharon Collins, both to keep the ball in the front court and tie up the ball as he was lying flat on his back. That was a big time play.
Well, he's a big time player. And Sharon, great play coming up with that fumble.
So Kansas gets the ball. The arrow now switches to K-State. Should we have another held ball situation?
Hey, maybe we're not going to be leaving here for a while. He's winking at us.
Denny Clemente just winked at this.
He's not nervous.
You know what? These kids are intense.
Well, here it is. Collins has the rock. They got the right guy with the ball. They're going to spread the court. A little 1-4. And he's going to drive. Is the one guy? Oh, he went down.
K-State's got it. 3 seconds. Sutton.
Did he get fouled? Did he get fouled? He wants a foul, Frank Martin. He wants a foul.
We are going to overtime. Collins still down behind the play. Danny Manning helping him to his feet. 40 minutes is not enough to settle this one here tonight.
Frank Martin wanted a foul down there on that last play.
What a crazy end to regulation.
He slips. A lot of perspiration on the floor. Collins goes down. Here comes the drive.
Good play by Reed.
Yeah, good play,
good play by Reed.
Good call by the officials. No call. 5 more minutes, buddy.
At least. The crowd just seeing the replay, but obviously seeing it with somewhat of a bias. It looked to us like Tyrell Reed just reached in with a left hand and knocked the ball away.
He gets us an all ball. He's looking at us, an all ball. He had all ball. He's smiling. I tell you what, these refs are earning their dollars here.
They are. The last overtime game in this series was 1989. A game that Kansas won here, 75-74. Overtime in a moment, but first, the preview of the upcoming X Games action. Here's Sal Masekela. Back here in Manhattan, these fans have been this energetic and enthusiastic since the day began. Better than 8,000 students showed up for game day this morning. This is a packed house and a house that has been alive all night long. The Octagon of Doom has been a fun place to watch a game, and we go to overtime here tonight.
Usually the edge goes to the home team when you truck overtime. You got Morris on the sideline with five. You got Aldridge with four. He's played very smart with four fouls. He challenged them and he didn't commit the fifth. Just elevated his arms. Look at these fans. They are so wired up.
Look at my partner here at the table. He's so wired.
And we'll be wired up next week. Michigan State invades Illinois with the Orange Crush. They got some terrific fans, some good young players as well.
Big minutes for the big guards in this game. Collins, 38. Morningstar, 34. Clemente, 38. Pullen, 36.
Well, that's the way it's supposed to be. Those guys are supposed to play those minutes. I like to get Jones around. He really has a good disposition.
And you know what? We've seen from the players an amazing amount of intensity tonight, but also some great sportsmanship, some smiling. Everybody in this building is having the time of their lives here tonight.
Kansas State only had 5 turnovers in the second half. Amazing. Kansas had 23 turnovers against Missouri and blew them out. Crushed them on a glass like a 2-1 ratio. See, they're zoning up in that area there with Aldridge. He just played a 3-second area.
Sutton over Aldridge.
Terrific move by Sutton. He's playing just to play passive in there.
Well, we have seen at times some triangle and two by Kansas. Playing a three-man zone, but playing a man-to-man on Clemente and Pullen.
A lot of teams will do that to those guards.
Taylor too strong, but we've got a foul call. It is impossible to hear the whistle.
Okay, Taylor's giving him positive minutes. Watch right now, Sutton challenging him on the inside spins. See, he just elevates his hands. It's all he can do. He can't really go to attack the basket.
Taylor's knocked down all 6 of his free throws tonight.
You must have jinxed him. You didn't jinx him. Just about everything go down. Just like when fans of Kentucky would tell him, the president came out and talked to us the day we lost to South Carolina. He cost us the win. I said, no, baby. Devin Downey pushed you here.
1 of 2 for Taylor. Kansas State will inbound to the 1-point lead here early in overtime.
You know, when you're Kansas, we talk about North Carolina. We certainly talk about Duke, who today got beaten. Georgetown played brilliantly. But those clubs get everybody's best hit everywhere they go. I mean, they really become a standard where clubs elevate their seasons if they can get a W against them.
And this is the best K-State team that Kansas has played in a while. They're 17-3, 13th in the nation. Aldridge got a piece of it. Kelly follows up his own miss and is fouled.
I like Curtis Kelly. He's demonstrating here at Kansas State why he was a big-time recruit when he came out of high school and went to UConn.
Taylor fouled him from behind. And Kelly at the line, 64% on the season.
You know, we're in overtime. Kansas came in this game, 4th leading scoring team in America, 85 points a game. Free throw line,
yep.
Would be a disaster. 253rd among Division I schools, Kansas State.
Both teams down in the 60s in their free throw percentage in this game. Kansas has been more often, but a shot a slightly worse percentage. Rebound, Markieff Morris. 2 critical misses by Kelly.
We're talking about critical in overtime.
He's hanging his head a little bit. He's got to forget about that. Play some defense now.
Pullen's doing a good job keeping the ball away from Collins.
Taylor with a big basket and a foul. It'll be on Dominique Sutton, and you said it, Tyshawn Taylor, who's had an up-and-down season, Dick. He's given them some big minutes tonight.
Oh, he's been a very positive force. They're doing a great job keeping the ball away from Collins, and he's just taking them one-on-one right here. Those are the things that he did last.
Continue to work on Sharon Collins, who has checked back into the game. Back and leg issues for Collins, but he's back in there as KU tries to hang on to a 1-point lead. Less than a minute to go in overtime here at the Bramlage. More clock issues. This time it appeared to be the game clock. the officials are looking at. Did it freeze and then did it run down too long after the whistle blew? And there also appeared to be some dispute as to whether or not Frank Martin actually called the timeout.
He said he didn't call the timeout.
But for whatever reason, somebody thought he did. He was charged with a timeout. He's still got one left. Kansas has one left as well. K-State has the basketball.
Referee's looking at the monitor, telling Kansas to go back to the sideline.
And keep an eye on the game clock. It stops there. The whistle blows. The offensive foul is called. A minute left right there. But as we look at it right now, it says 53.5. So at some point, for whatever reason, seven the clock seconds. Started running again.
So they're going to add over 7 seconds to that clock.
Yeah, they got to put it back to a minute, we would think. And I tell you, Duke Edsel and Scott Thornley and Paul Jansen have had as busy a night as officials can have in as intense an environment as you can imagine. And I think you'd agree they've done a terrific job.
Terrific here. Job. And the key is to get it right now. And utilizing the monitor should make it easy for them to get it right.
57.5 is what they've decided on.
I must be bad at math. I thought you were going to add it to a minute.
And 2 seconds off the shot clock. Kansas State looking for the lead. Clemente with the ball, pulling, running around some baseline screens, trying to get free.
Stepping out, Aldridge, he does a great job stepping out.
Clemente misses the three. Markieff Morris the rebound. Now what do you do? 5 second difference, game clock and shot clock.
You got a foul.
But you don't want to foul Collins if you can avoid it.
But you got can't let him take all his time down.
They're going to play it out.
You got a foul Morris.
At this point, they're going to play it out. Timeout Kansas. And the first thing, one of the things you think about, Dick, the two lane violations on Kansas State and how costly they are in a game like this.
Oh, absolutely. You think also about missing free throws down the other end.
A 1 point lead for Kansas in a game, Dick, that has had 20 lead changes.
It's been everything, as you said earlier, yeah. Dan, is advertised. A lot of intensity, a lot of emotion. You're Kansas State, you're the fans here. You don't want a moral victory. You don't want to play them close. You want to get a W. You want to prove that you can beat them. That's just the story. Look at the intensity on that sideline. These fans are all fired up.
All right, Dick, at this point, 16.2 on the game clock, 11 on the shot clock. Kansas with the ball in a 1 point lead. Would you foul or do you just play it out at this point? Hope you get a stop and you've got 5 seconds to try to make something happen.
I would have fouled a little bit earlier. I would not take it down to a 5 second situation. 5 seconds, you're almost hoping and praying for a miracle.
Kansas has used its final timeout. Kansas State still has one.
Okay, one thing impresses me, the poise of the Kansas kids. They never seem to get rattled. And a crowd, they just keep poised. Get the ball in the hands of the right guy.
Collins gets inside.
Oh, what an
incredible play by Sharon Collins.
But he's done that his entire career.
This is a guy 2-3 minutes ago had trouble walking off the court, comes back in and makes the play of the game.
Absolutely the play of the game, Dan. Look at the super strength on that body to be able to challenge the defense, to hang in the air, to convert. An incredible play right there. I thought they made a mistake by fouling a lot earlier. I thought they should have fouled a lot earlier, especially when the ball was not in the hands of Collins.
The foul on Wally Judge, he's out of the game. The All-American just made an All-American Akita play. And not only that, he is the best free throw shooter in the Big 12 at 87%. And if he can knock it down, it's a two-possession game.
Absolutely. That changes the whole chance. Because now you have some questions to ask. If you were to miss it, do you foul if you can just not allow him to get a three-point attempt with somebody like Bullitt who could knock the three down?
Just incredible strength by Sharon Collins to turn the corner, muscle it up and in, and now he looks for the four-point lead.
See, I don't understand the strategy of not fouling prior to that. Earlier, it was like 30-some seconds. This kid made an incredible drive.
He missed it. Aldrich the rebound.
One All-American makes a big play, then the other All-American.
Another missed opportunity. Look at the expressions on the faces of the K-State players after a missed free throw. They had the ball. They had an opportunity to secure the rebound and go down to tie it and let it slip away.
They lose this game. It'd be two tough losses at home with Oklahoma State and now with Kansas. You can't lose on your home floor if you're dreaming of winning the conference championship.
And the Morningstar has made it a two-possession game. Heartbreak for Kansas State. And give KU a lot of credit. Bill Self yelling, no fouls, no fouls.
Give Kansas a lot of credit for the way they hung in there with foul trouble. Aldridge with four, Morris with five. Big offensive rebound and a missed free throw by Aldridge. And an incredible play by Collins to win the game.
It'll count for Pullen to make the final 81-79. Kansas wins on the road, and they're going to be the number one team in America when the new poll comes out after Kentucky lost earlier this week. Heartbreak city for K-State, but what a gutty performance by Kansas here in as hostile an environment as they'll see all season.
Well, a hostile environment and a good quality team they beat. Kansas State is a legitimate top 15 basketball team. Get on the offensive boards big time, good guard play. But Kansas found a way to win, something they've been doing their entire life down there in Jayhawk land. Bill Self gets another step closer to the 400 mark. Now he needs four more wins to get the 400.
Again, the play of the game, and this was just after he left the game with what looked like multiple injuries, back and leg problems. Sharon Collins comes back in, gets around two K-State defenders, goes right into the body of another in Judge, holds him off, completes the shot, and that was the biggest basket in this game tonight.
Absolutely a difference maker. We kept talking about the fact that he's the special, unique player, that you got to keep the ball out of his hands. He's just one of those winners. They're rare. The Tebows, the Jeters, the Peyton Mannings,
and
they're
rare. Look at this sportsmanship and this mutual respect we're seeing from these two teams here tonight.
Yes,
this is
great.
Two guys right here, and Collins and Pullen, who have known each other for many, many years since they grew up, both of them in Chicago. Aaron Andrews is with one of the stars of the game, Sharon Collins.
Who just told me, Dan, that he's hurting. What happened to you?
I got cramp. I mean, I think I used too much energy getting ready for this game. Coach told me calm down earlier at pregame meal. So I was a little amped, and I think I just drained myself a little bit too much, and I was just start cramping. And I twisted my ankle on last play when Tyshawn threw it to me, and you know, in regulation. So I'm all right though. I just didn't want to lose it. Whatever. I just had to get stretched and finally get back in there.
Talk about how you were able to muscle up those final points for yourself on that last play there.
I told Coach, asked us what we want to run. I told him give me the ball. And he drew the same play that we ran against Cornell. And it was open, and I got to the basket. And I just used my ability to get that basket over Big Judge, because he's strong, but I'm strong too.
Coach told me before the game he was telling you guys, embrace this. Embrace being number one, which you will be now with this win. Talk about what does this win mean to you guys?
It means a lot, especially, you know, to come in here, this hostile environment. This is the toughest, probably the loudest place I've ever played in my 4 years. You know, they fans are great. It was game day. It's, you know, everybody watching. You know, so Coach, you know, he's the one thing he said, you know, we still Kansas regardless. And we got to play and we got to have our swag. And I think we came out with it.
Well, you got the swag. Thanks.
Thank you.
Great performance by Sharon Collins in this overtime win, making the biggest play of the game in overtime after the injury. Cole Aldrich had a big game and played a long time with four fouls, which is to his credit. Tyshawn Taylor gave KU some big minutes as well. But at the end, as it so often has been the last couple of years for Kansas, when they needed a big play, when they absolutely needed it, it was Sharon Collins. And Jacob Pullen, for much of the second half, played the same role for Kansas State.
Oh, it was a terrific play by Collins at the end to win this game. He showed so much fortitude and just toughness, an absolute winner's mentality to be able to convert after being injured, coming in. And we knew the ball was going to go to him because he's that one special player that wants the ball at crunch time. And he knows how to finish. He's been doing it his entire career.
Well, a great night of basketball, an overtime win here in Manhattan. Boy, did we have fun. We hope you had fun watching it here tonight. Number two, Kansas going to number one, you would imagine, after this win over K-State here tonight. Winner X Games 14 from Aspen is next here on ESPN. And for more on this game, we'll be over on ESPN News momentarily to wrap it up. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Dick Vitale, Airman Andrews, and our entire crew, I'm Dan Shulman saying thanks for watching and so long from Manhattan, Kansas.